Crews in Old City are covering a construction site where dozens of coffins were discovered. We were first to tell you about the discovery yesterday. Now researchers are analyzing the human remains that were found. Eyewitness News reporter David Spunt is live at Rutgers Camden, where he got an exclusive tour of the forensic lab. David.
Yuki, this is quite a story always developing. These remains were supposed to be removed from Old City by 1860 to another part of Philadelphia. Someone obviously didn't do their job. Now the folks here at Rutgers are picking up the slack, and they expect to be doing so for the next few weeks at least. These bones are at least 200 years old, and now they're in a locked lab at Rutgers in Camden. Despite the cold snap and morning snow dusting, archaeologists were back as the sun rose, digging up even more coffins from the mid-1700s.
Apparently, the weather's going to get even worse next week, so we really want to make sure that, while it's still workable, that we're trying to finish up this project.
Kimberly Moran is a forensic archaeologist with Rutgers University and met us at the snowy site of the First Baptist Church burial ground. So far, her colleagues have uncovered at least 3 dozen wooden coffins and hundreds of remains. But the snow slowed things down.
Some of the work is just not possible. It's just too muddy. Some of the removal of the coffins, we can't do. We can't really subject it to these sorts of conditions.
In many cases, the coffins are in such bad shape that crews are recovering only skeletons. We can't show you on television, but many of the skeletons are in near perfect condition. One had a full head of hair. Moran calls the preservation remarkable. Across the river in Camden, Moran took us to the forensics lab on the Rutgers campus. Bones and other small artifacts line tables. This metal nameplate was discovered on one of the coffins. Crews hope to be able to find out what it says.
Normally I'm dealing with murder investigations. I'm dealing with people that have only been dead for at most a couple of years. And to get to work with bones that are a couple centuries old is really, really exciting.
It's also possible, I'm told, that there could be more coffins in the ground that just haven't been discovered yet. Crews here at Rutgers University in Camden, they plan on discovering the age, the race, and the sex of these people that passed away almost 300 years ago. They believe the earliest could have been 1707. Reporting live tonight, David Spunt, CBS 3 Eyewitness News.
All right, David, thank you.